this video, I made a rookie error and I didn't have a mirror in front of me, and I had some 99 cent lip gloss on my snaggle tooth throughout the entire video. So now I'm refilming everything. Also, that quote was from Mean Girls, in case you didn't know. You should know, because come on. This is my August favorites. I know you guys are thinking, this girl is sitting down in front of a camera. When last have we seen this? It was about time to start doing some sit down videos, because you guys have said you like those as well. And it was perfect timing for August favorites. So we'll just get into this. It's like I'm chatting to my friends. First thing from August favorites is to do with my hair, because I've had a cut. I don't know if you watched that vlog or not. If you haven't, I'll link it up over here. I think it was like 2 vlogs ago, maybe even my most recent one. I don't know anymore. So this is the Lee Stafford Sea Salt Spray, the Beach Babe one. I don't know if that's the variety of the sea salt spray, but I got this straight after I had my hair cut. Basically, I needed some lift at the roots. I needed it to be something that I could put in my hair straight after I washed it, like a wash and go kind of vibe. It would just be easy and simple. And this is exactly that. It also smells amazing. I love it. I sprayed it in my hair straight after I've washed it, towel dried it. Spray this in, it makes my curls kind of normal. I don't think it does much to my curls. It just doesn't add frizz, which is really great for someone with curly hair. And then also it gives some extra kind of grit and hold at the roots. I haven't tried to style my hair yet, but for now I like the kind of wash and go vibe that this allows me. And I think this was like 100 and something rand, it clicks. And then the next thing is something I've been using on my body. It is a household name. I'm pretty sure all of you have heard of it. It's a very normal brand. And I went to an event for them just the other day. This is a bio oil product. This is the normal bio oil, but it is in a little tester size. It's 25 ml. This is new to them. And so I thought after that event, I was like, well, if it's worked for all of these women, it could definitely work for me. So I have powered through this really quickly, but it is a really tiny one. So it's nice to kind of pop in your handbag, or if you're traveling. I actually took this to Joburg with me, which you guys will see, I think, in the next vlog that's coming up somewhere. And I've just really been enjoying this. My skin is also surprisingly smooth. Like usually it's like snake skin or like bumpy. I'm really just painting a great picture of myself here, aren't I? And I find that my skin is actually a lot smoother. I haven't seen like any noticeable difference for the stretch marks just yet, but I'm hoping that it'll help. And if it does, I will definitely keep you guys posted, probably on the blog. This is something that I used during drugstore week. I picked this up in my drugstore haul and I've been using it ever since then. I absolutely love it. I just bought it on a whim, and this is the NYX Dewy Finish Long Lasting Setting Spray. I think I've used like 3/4 of it, so it's almost finished, which kind of shows how much I love it. And it's definitely a lot more affordable than using my Urban Decay All Night Setting Spray, which I love, but this is kind of nice for everyday wear. I love the finish that this gives. I feel like it actually does make my skin look more dewy and kind of luminous. And it is very alcohol based. Like, you definitely smell alcohol when you spray this on your face, which is not ideal. But once it's set, it's perfectly fine. No problems, can't smell any alcohol. So I really like this, and I think it's like 100 and something rand. You can get it clicks. This concealer combo I've been wearing kind of non-stop for about a month and a half, maybe 2 months. This is the Smashbox Studio Skin 24-hour waterproof concealer. And I have this in the shade light medium. This is the one that is a little bit too dark for me. I'm the shade warm light, or light warm, something like that. And I mix it in with the LA Girl Pro Conceal in the shade natural. These two are a wonderful combo. They both work equally well separately, but then put together, I think they are a wonderful combo, and I just love it underneath my eyes. It's a good amount of coverage. It covers dark circles wonderfully. Both of them do a good job separately, but then also together. I really, really love them. And then for mascara, this is a new one for me. I'm someone that needs length and volume. I can't just do volume, it doesn't work for me. But somehow this mascara has worked for me, and this is the Maybelline The Colossal Big Shot Volume Express Mascara. The wand is quite a fat wand, and the bristles are kind of jagged. They come out at all the different edges. They're all different lengths, and I find that it actually helps to grab onto every single eyelash. I am wearing it right now on my upper lashes, and I've been wearing it pretty much every single time I wear makeup, and I like the way it looks. It looks really good. I mean, it could definitely do with more length, but I'm happy with the way my lashes look. This has done a great job. The product that I'm wearing on my lips is also Maybelline. It was in that same big press drop, which I'm so excited about. It was in a vlog, so I'll link that up over here, whatever side it is. This is the Maybelline Vivid Hot Lacquer in the shade Charmer. I have raved about this on my vlogs, on my Instagram, pretty much everywhere. And I've just been loving this. I've been wearing it almost every single time I wear makeup. I like the kind of gloss it gives. Also, I wrote a blog post about my favorite kind of glossy lip product. So if you want to go and see that, it is 4 of my top glossy lip products, and this is one of them. I really, really love this. It's kind of like a rosy, pinky browny shade, which is right up my alley. You guys know this by now. So if you want to go check out that blog post, I will link it up over here, and then also it'll be in the description box so you can go and take a look at that. I will also be doing more blog posts, which I'll mention at the end of the video. And then this is another new product. It's actually limited edition, but it is beautiful. This is the Clarins limited edition bronze and blush compact. They come up with a new kind of bronze blush compact like this every single year in their summer collection. This is always a standout product. I mean, the packaging is beautiful. It's giving me kind of island vibes, which is exactly what a summer product should. They always emboss really cool patterns in the bronzer, and I freaking love it. This has one kind of blush shade at the bottom. It's kind of a burnt orange. It has a gold shimmer running through it, but I think it's beautiful. And then the rest of it is one shade of bronzer. I love this shade. I'm wearing it right now. I love it. I wonder if I could apply a little bit more. Swirl my brush into the bronzer, and then on the cheekbones, also on the temples, on the forehead. And then if I'm not wearing makeup, so on days where it's just kind of like a tinted moisturizer run and go vibe, I'll put it on my eyelids as well to kind of get that very bronzy, islandy, summery vibe. And then also on the bridge of my nose and my chin and down my neck, and it just gives it an overall beautiful bronzy vibe, which I'm good for and I love. These are totally worth picking up. I absolutely love this one. And then an eyeshadow palette that I've been using non-stop since I got it, Urban Decay Naked Ultimate Basics palette. So it has 12 matte shades and they are all beautiful. They're all super wearable. I've used quite a few of them. This nudie shade over here is a more flesh tone shade. I just use that to set my eyeshadow primer. And then Commando is also really, really beautiful. I like that in the crease. But what I'm wearing today is nudie all over. And then I'm wearing Faith in the crease, and I've been wearing this non-stop. This combo is beautiful. I love this shade, and I love a matte palette because I really get a lot of use out of this. This is kind of like an everyday palette for me. I took this with me to Johannesburg when I went to the Woolworths event, and this was the only eyeshadow palette I took, and it worked beautifully. On to fashion favorites. The first one will come as no surprise. I've been wearing this non-stop. If you watch my vlogs, you will know this is the only pair of pants that I've been wearing, and I freaking love it. These are my Zara culottes. They're essentially wide leg culottes. They have a little tie in the front. Because I'm short, I always thought that I couldn't wear culottes, but I'm actually able to wear these and I love them and I get lots of compliments on them. You guys always say you like them. Whenever I put up a picture with me wearing these, there's so many questions about them. I got them on sale at Zara. They were 200 and something rand, but their normal price is about 480 maybe, which is not bad for a pair of pants. And I like these because I can wear them in summer as well. I can pair them with pretty much anything, and they've literally been glued to my body. And then the next one is a new item which you will see in a haul and try on video, but it's coming very soon. I'm just waiting on a few items to get here. And this is my new Country Road black faded denim jacket. I love this thing. I'm not going to show it too much because I am going to talk about it in that video as well, but it is an absolute beautiful piece. And then the last thing is this t-shirt that I'm currently wearing. I just got to show you the sleeves. They've got these little like frilly sleeves, which makes it a little bit more fun. It makes it less of like a plain gray t-shirt, and I love it. It's really nice to wear with my culottes or my denim jacket, and you will see it in that same haul and try on video as well. This is going to seem like a little bit of a random favorite, but the husband and I have been trying to be more healthy. We've gone to gym a lot. I went to gym 4 times last week. If you're following me on Twitter, you already know this. I felt the need to tweet it because I was like, I've never been to gym this many times in a week. So this has helped me to make sure that I drink enough water every single day. Mr. Price sent over a really cool kind of stationery and gifting package. It was just to kind of tell me about their new gifting range, which I will write a blog post about. If it's gone up already, I will link it over here. But this bottle was in the package and I absolutely love it. It was literally the best gift ever. It says H2O, the gasoline of life, which I think is a really cool statement. I like the bottle, it's glass. Then also on the back, it has the time for the day. So it starts at 8, ends at 5 p.m. It means that you drink all the water that you need to in your normal day. And it's perfect for if you're in a normal kind of day-to-day job, you can just stick this on your desk, you can have a glass, you can kind of drink out of the bottle, and it just means that you do get your 2 liters of water in every single day. So I've really been enjoying that, and they are at Mr. Price. You can get it online, you can get it in store, and I think they have different variants of this, so definitely go and get that if you need to drink more water. The first blog that I've really been enjoying reading is Poppy Days. I really enjoy her style. She has the same kind of body type to me, so I feel like if she wears something, I could totally try and pull it off. Like, I saw her wearing culottes and I was like, ooh, she's pretty short. I could definitely try some culottes. So I've really been enjoying her style. Her blog is beautiful. I like her photography. She also has beauty stuff on there. She has food stuff. She's just kind of like a personality that I actually enjoy. So it's really fun to read her blog, and I've just really been enjoying that. Next one is kind of my inspirational something for the month. I've been following the Anna Edit, which is Anna Gardner, and I've been following her for a while, and she always puts up 5 blog posts a week. So a new blog post every single day, Monday to Friday. And I just, I'm like, that's so inspirational. She does it full time. She does 2 videos as well. If she can do 5 blog posts and 2 videos in 1 week, how can I not? How can I not push myself to do that as well? So I'm gonna chat more about this at the end of the video, about what I'm wanting to do blog-wise on YouTube. And you guys can let me know in the comments what you think of it. But for now, I've just found her so inspirational that she's able to do that. And it's like fresh content and the photos are beautiful. Yeah, I'm really, really inspired by her. I love her videos as well. I'll leave all the links to these people in the description box. And then I've also written down a couple of things that I wanna chat about really, really quickly. I have been vlogging a lot. And I know that you guys have been enjoying it, but I also want to do more sit-down videos like this. I just want to kind of find a way to enjoy my sit-down videos again, because I just found that they were a bit boring and stagnant and just like, bleh. If I'm not enjoying it, you guys are not gonna enjoy it. So please leave me comments down below with like 5 suggestions. I know there's a lot of suggestions, but I mean, as many as you can think of that I could film, I would really, really enjoy that. And I've also been wanting to do, let me know if you would enjoy this, Vlogtober. Because October is my birthday, and I'm thinking of like putting together really cool content, whether it's sit-down videos or vlogs. Leave comments down below if you want to see that. I want to do sit-down videos as well, and I want to make them different. So not all beauty. I want to do fashion, I want to do beauty, I want to do home stuff. So let me know if you would enjoy that in the comments. And then I am pushing myself, this is what I was saying when I was talking about Anna's blog. I'm going to push myself to do 3 blog posts a week. So Monday, Wednesday, Friday, they are going to be fashion related, beauty, it's gonna be lifestyle, it's gonna be home, it's gonna be a restaurant review. Maybe if you're a reading person, you're not really wanting to watch a video, maybe you wanna just scroll through a blog while you're at work because you can't watch a video, that'd be a good option for you. So if you guys are excited about that, please go check out the blog. That's it. I hope that you guys have enjoyed this, and if you have, please give it a thumbs up. That really helps me to know that you're enjoying the videos. I know some people aren't people who comment. So if you're not a commenter, give this video a thumbs up and let me know that you've enjoyed it. Also, if you are someone that comments, then leave a comment down below, suggestions and stuff like that. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.